Hey Gemini, welcome to Alexander Tarot. This is going to be a March 2024 reading for Gemini, for those who have Gemini placements. Check your chart for your placements. It's for Sun, Moon, Venus, and Rising. Cross watchers, as well, always, you're welcome here. Keep in mind that energy is fluid, so the roles may be reversed. You may flip the messages as needed if necessary, but never force it. If it's for you, it will flow. Never force the reading, all right? Time is also fluid. Anytime that you press play is the time for you to receive the messages. If the reading resonates, guys, please sure to be engaging. Press the like button, subscribe to my channel, share, like, comment, anything, okay? It helps me to connect to as many of you as possible, and it helps me to connect to your energies, all right? So let's get right into it, guys. Also, if you're interested in a personal reading, you can click on the link in the description box below. Show me the messages, please, for Gemini. What does Gemini need to see in love? What is Gemini's current situation in love? Thank you so much, Spirit. I'm so truly grateful. Okay, what I'm getting in your connection is that there's somebody here that is completely drained, exhausted, just tired. I'm getting the energy of somebody who feels burnt out and they're just trying to contemplate their next move. This is somebody that has been very unstable in this connection, Nine of Pentacles reverse, very reckless. This is someone who's quiet. They're not listening to their intuition, but they are contemplating their next move. But it's like they're wanting to come in with the Knight of Wands, with passion. But yeah, this is the thing with this person, okay? I have the Strength reversed. This person is feeling vulnerable. This person is feeling inadequate. Their self-esteem is kind of low right now. This person could be having money problems. So there's financial instability here. You could be connecting with a Leo. Show me more, please. This is someone who doesn't really want to conform, who hasn't been conforming, I should say, to a traditional relationship of wanting to be committed. They just kind of just non-committal. But this is also somebody that hasn't moved on and intends to return. Eight of Cups reverse. Why is this Eight of Cups reverse here? Wow, okay, so this is somebody that wants to be accountable for their behavior, okay? This is someone that wants to apologize. And I feel like, I'm telling you, justice for me is my reunion card in a lot of readings. And I feel like this person does desire a reunion. The only thing that's keeping this person from coming in is the fear of rejection, not feeling like they're not enough for you because of their instabilities. Show me the breakdown in this connection, please. What was the breakdown? This person has been playing a lot of mind games with you. The energy is coming off very manipulative. Magician reverse. You could be connecting with another Gemini, or this could be your energy. I feel like this person is like spying on you. Again, there's a curiosity to see if you're with someone, if you've moved on. But with the Eight of Swords reversed, this is somebody that wants to come out of some stuck energy that they were in. But I'm asking for the breakdown, right? Part of the breakdown is this person was playing mind games with you. Why is this Magician reversed here? This person couldn't make up their mind about you. King of Cups. This person could be talking to somebody. Somebody who's very emotionally mature, giving them good, solid advice. They can also be seeing a therapist. A lot of times the King of Cups can be some sort of therapy, or just somebody that's therapeutic to them. It could be a friend, it could be a family member. Yeah, they're wanting a new cycle. This person is encouraging your person to begin a new cycle with you, okay? With the Wheel of Fortune. All right, let's see if this card spirit is gonna show me a breakdown. The cards only tell you what they want you to know, okay? Yeah, this person wants success with you. They want to come in with stability. They're trying to recover from their toxic ways. You can be connecting with a Capricorn. I'm also getting strong Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. Yeah, this person is going through some sort of transformation. Again, there's somebody here that's helping them with this. The King of Cups doesn't necessarily mean that it's not, that it has to be a man. The cards are not gender-based. But there's, it could be even like a parent, like a mother or an uncle or an aunt. It's somebody, grandmother, somebody close to this person is helping this person transform into a new way of being, I should say. They're trying to purge out their old ways. Spirit, show me the breakdown, please. Is there a breakdown here? Okay, yes. Okay, your person was making a lot of hasty, reckless decisions when it came to this Queen of Wands reverse. This could be an ex of theirs. This could be somebody that they have a child or children with. This is somebody that they have some sort of past with, okay? And I feel like they were making very reckless decisions. Your person wasn't being reliable in the connection, because they were just making these hasty decisions when it came to this Queen of Wands reverse. I feel like it had to do with money in some way. They may have a child or children with this person, or some sort of investment. But this person can't be trusted. This person is selfish. This person is someone that desires your person still. And I feel like with the Nine of Wands, you tried to deal with this situation. You were pushing through, even though it was draining. You just, like, you stayed in that situation, dealing with this person's behavior for as long as possible. And you just kept pushing through. Like, you know what? This is not going to last forever. Like, this is going to change. This is going to get better. And I just feel like it never got better. There's a lot of fire energy here. You could be connected with an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, or somebody who has fire in their chart. But that was the breakdown, was this interference in the way that your person was handling any situation with this Queen of Wands reverse. Okay. Show me why the Fool is here. Okay. Show me one more, please. You want a new beginning with your person. I got the Ace of Cups here. There's a lot of emotions. There's a lot of love that you feel for this person, but you pulled back your emotions with the Queen of Cups reversed. But you do desire a new beginning with this person. You desire it, but you're like, I'm not going to make the move. Like, I'm not going to this person. I've been through a lot, but there's a lot of raw emotions here that you, and a lot of love that you do feel for this person. You could be connected with a Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces. Or you can have water signs in your chart. You're like, I'm not willing to go to this person. This person put me through a lot. If this person comes to you, though, you're willing to end the conflict between you two. You want to end the drama. Five of Wands reverse. You're wanting to compromise with this person, but you are not reaching out to this person. All right, so show me Gemini's person's feelings for Gemini currently. What is their feelings? There's something going on with this person right now that they're not happy about with the Queen of Wands reverse, okay? And they're feeling very overwhelmed with the Two of Pentacles reverse. They have a lot of responsibilities, and they're overwhelmed with trying to balance it all. That's why I got the energy of somebody feeling tired and contemplating. It's your person. They're not happy with their situation. They're not even happy with their involvement with this Queen of Wands reverse. With the Moon reverse, there's something that that will be revealed. And it's not good news. Spirit, clarify what this is that will be revealed. You could be connecting with the Pisces. What is this that will be revealed? Tell me one more, please. This person from the past, they want your person for themselves. And this is a situation where your person does not want this person that wants them, this Queen of Wands reverse. They don't want to be with this person again. There was a relationship. This is somebody that they were with in the past. They have a history with this person. Again, I'm getting children or a child, but they clearly do not want to be with this person. With the Emperor reverse, they're resisting this person. However, with the Page of Pentacles reverse, I usually get that for like breadcrumbing energy. Show me why the Page of Pentacles reverse is here. Okay, they're being very strategic about what they're giving this person. They're not letting this person take advantage of them. They want you to know that. Like, I do have the situation under the control. I'm being very strategic. But the Four of Wands reversed, I'm telling you, and the Six of Cups reversed, your person wants to tell you that they do not want this person. They'll never be back with this person again. It's like over. They're only doing with the Page of Pentacles reversed. They're doing just what they're supposed to do for this person financially and nothing more. That is what they want to reveal to you. You could be connecting with an Aries spirit. Show me more for this person's feelings for Gemini. Look at that. You're their person. You're their person, Gemini. This person wants to show you that they do value. They want to show up for you the way that you show up for them. They want to come together. They want to make this work. And Three of Pentacles in this reading is also about co-parenting. This person is like, okay, I want to do what I need to do for our relationship. I do want to come together. I do want to make it work. I'm miserable without you. But I need to strategically set this up so that I am there for you and I take care of my responsibilities with my ex. And with the Nine of Swords reversed, this is somebody who wants to recover. They want to recover from this connection. Strong Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy. They want to make this work with you. So show me Gemini's feelings for this person. You're resistant, you're stubborn. You don't, at this point, you're not willing to compromise. You feel like your person makes too many hasty decisions. You don't feel like you can count on them. But the thing is, it's your feelings versus, it's your emotions versus your logic. Your logic is no, like, leave them, like, I don't want to deal with this. You know, this is this Queen of Swords reversed. The stubbornness is your logical approach. Temperaments reversed, you're like, this person is just, this situation has been so reckless. But with the Eight of Wands, you wish a person would take action. You wish they would reach out. You desire that, but you're like, I'm not willing to do it. Like, you're so stubborn, you're not going to reach out to this person. All right, show me why the Eight of Wands is here. Yeah, you're like, your person would need to take action in order to get things moving. You're not doing it because of all the pain that this person caused you. Okay, because the way that the last time that it ended, it was like, this is it, this is over, nail in a coffin, you went too far, the situation's going too far, I've had enough. You feel like your person treated you like a doormat. So it was so painful, and the exchange was so painful that you're not going to be the one to reach out. Okay, but show me the challenges. What are the challenges when it comes to this connection for Gemini? Your challenge is to want the reunion. Because with the King of Swords reversed, you feel like this person is very flighty, very reckless. It doesn't last long. This person comes in, everything's going good for a while, then there's some sort of drama, and then this person leaves again. So you're like, I don't want that. Do I really want to be in a situation where someone keeps hurting me, keeps coming and going? Show me advice, please. What advice do we have? A lot of times when I ask for advice, spirit shows me the current situation first. With the King of Swords reversed, you feel like your person's very aloof. Like, they don't care. They're not showing any interest. And what you didn't even know until you came into this reading that this person has all these emotions and love that they want to express to you. You know, emotions that they've never expressed before. You feel like your person is taking you for granted. You feel burdened by the situation. You feel like they have too much going on, and then it becomes their problems become your problem. As the Empress, you recognize your worth. You're a very high level person, very committed. For some of you, you may have a child with this person as well. So it's like, this is why this person is feeling overwhelmed. They want to bring balance between you and the ex who has a child or children with them. This person, for some of you, has multiple children. Okay? That's not going to resonate with everyone. But it's like, you know what your worth is. You're like, I can't keep taking on all of this from somebody who's not even, like, why am I even caring about this? And this person is not showing me any interest whatsoever now, you know? I feel like this person went quiet. You could be connected with a Libra. Show me advice. Why is a Chariot here? Somebody who's non-committed is gonna take action. You're gonna hear from this person. This person wants this to work. You know, they had all these issues, these money problems, but they're trying to move forward from that. They want to come towards you. This is somebody that can, you know, can't make their mind about, like, couldn't make their mind up about you. And now they're making a decision to take action. You're going to hear from this person. All right. Show me advice. Okay. There it is. There it is. Okay. The advice is to recover this connection. There is an opportunity for happiness between you and this person. A Nine of Cups. This could be a wish fulfillment. This separation had to happen for this person to see just how much they love you. They couldn't see it in a connection. They saw it after they lost you. Because this time, something was different about this time. And they're like, oh shit, like, Gemini is not reaching out to me. I feel like you usually reach out first when you guys are separated. And this time you didn't do that. Your stubbornness and your resistance is making this person want you more. And with the world, there's a new cycle, a new beginning here. This is your soulmate. Okay? So there's an opportunity to recover this. Okay, so please don't be in my comments saying you don't want this person. Use your discernment. Everything is a choice, okay? You have free will. You know, nothing's etched in stone. I'm pulling the energies. I'm telling you this person wants to come back. They want to come back with accountability. They want to explain some things to you. They want to be vulnerable with you. They want to commit to you. They want to strategically make this work, okay? So you decide what you want. You use your discernment. But what I'm telling you is there's an opportunity. And you, if you decide to be with this person, you will finally get what you want, all right? So before I close out this reading, I'm going to pull some oracle messages, all right? I'm going to pull a few oracle messages. First, I'm going to pull from this Messages of Love oracle deck. I'm going to pull in your person's feelings more because I feel like they made some decisions, a lot of decisions that they regret. Sometimes people can't see themselves until they're forced to be on their own. And then they're like, they have no choice but to look at what they've done. Show me the messages, please, for Gemini. Daydreaming. I am always longing for you. Yeah, this person, I feel like, is in their head all the time, thinking about you, wanting you, desiring you. It's why they keep returning. That's why they keep returning. They're like, why do I feel this way? Reminiscing. I miss out inside jokes. Yeah, this person is thinking about you a lot. Unfinished business. We still have things to resolve and discuss. Yeah. So this person knows. They're like, they know that this is not over. You feel that it is because, again, your person is very aloof. There's no communication. Sabotage. I messed up the good things in my life sometimes. And this is what this person has been doing. Because they just get emotionally overwhelmed. Then they're emotional immaturity kicks in and they start acting out. Reciprocity, I want to have equal give and take. Yeah, I told you this person wants to show you that they do value you. Conversation, I want to call you and hear your voice. All right, so you're going to hear from this person. This person wants to come in with a lot of passion. All right, show me the messages, please. When it comes to matters of the heart, there is no right or wrong. Every choice we make expands. Every choice you make expands your understanding of life and love. Love is not emotional. I mean, logical, it's emotional. So there is no right or wrong. Every choice you make expands your understanding of life and love. That's just how it happens. Sometimes it's just love. And you're like, well, why do I still feel drawn to this person? This person is not even speaking to me. Because you are so deeply connected with this person that when you feel them, and you're thinking about them, they're feeling you and thinking about you. Imagine all unwanted thoughts dissolving into light, creating room for new opportunities and possibilities for your life. Thoughts become things, okay? You're resistant because you don't want to get hurt because you've been hurt enough. And you feel like this person let a lot of shit happen when it came to this ex that they shouldn't have. And they need to put that situation in a smash. But you can manifest it by changing your thought process. If this is what you want, you would have to allow yourself to create the emotional space to welcome this change, okay? Only time will tell, okay? And that's for those of you who are like, well, what if I go back and I get disappointed and this person hurts me again and we break up again and they leave again and I don't have time to waste. What if I waste my time? Being with someone that you love is about taking a chance. Even if you move on, you're taking a chance with someone new. You have to be willing to be transparent. You have to be willing to take the chance. When you love someone, you're always putting yourself in a position to allow the person to hurt you and just hoping that they don't, you know, having faith that they don't. You've been hurt by this person a lot, but it doesn't mean that it has to continue, Gemini. The past is now behind you. Release it and embrace new possibilities. A new path is now available to you. Follow it with faith. I just finished saying that. Just put the past, sit with your feelings. They're valid, and I'm not minimizing them. Process them, sit with them, and release them. Because when this person comes back in, you don't want to dwell on the past. You want to discuss it, process it, and release it. Because you can't unring a bell. The focus is, okay, what are we going to do now? Freedom. There's nothing stopping you. The path is clear if you want it to be. Okay? So this is really about you letting this go. You know, sitting with it again, processing your feelings and releasing it and clearing the path. Because when you do that, that's when this person is going to come in energetically. They're going to feel this and they're going to come in. It's all divine timing. But your resistance right now is keeping this from happening. Because the spirit is aligning with your energy and you're like, I want to be protected right now. I don't want this person to hurt me. And that's why this person hasn't come in, because you're not ready to receive it. But once you say, okay, you know what? I do love this person. I do want to hear what this person has to say. I do want to allow this person to prove to me that things are going to change. I do want to take my time and rebuild with them. Watch how it aligns and the universe brings it in. Okay? So those are the messages that I have for you for this reading, Gemini. If it resonated, again, be sure to, you know, subscribe to my channel, to tap the like button, to leave a comment. I always respond to my comments. I wish you guys healing. I wish you love and light as always. And I'll see you again on the next one. Bye.